Will the market go up or down? Should you lock in or float? Find out this and more with Master of the Markets, hosted by Barry Habib of MBS Highway. Brought to you by Paramount Residential Mortgage Group.
In today's mortgage environment, providing our wholesale community with the best combination of product, pricing, technology, and service is paramount to their success. PRMG, built by originators for originators.
Welcome to another edition of Master of the Markets. I'm Barry Habib, and MBS Highway is created exclusively for Mortgage News Network, and it's brought to you by our friends at PRMG. They're working for your best interest. What a week last week. Yeah, it was jobs week, and the jobs number was a little disappointing on job creations, but the unemployment rate dropped to 3.5%. That's the lowest since 1969. Wow. So bonds held in there pretty good. As you know, the 10-year Treasury's done well too. Why is that? Well, the big component that we always look at are weekly earnings, not hourly earnings, because you can work less hours and have your wages still cut on a week-to-week basis. When you want to talk about money people have, look at weekly earnings. Most people don't know that. So when we looked at weekly earnings, it was trending at 2.9% per year. That dropped to 2.6. So yeah, people are working, but they're not getting raises. And that's good for bonds because that means less wage pressure inflation. Remember, bonds hate inflation because it erodes that fixed payment that bondholders receive. So the longer you can sustain buying power, the more valuable bonds are. Based upon some of the other data, that 3.5% unemployment rate, sure, that gets a lot of headlines, but it's based on something called the household survey. It's very, very volatile. And for those people who are looking at that and saying, oh, how can we have recession? Recessions always occur, not when unemployment rate is high, but when it reaches its lowest level. So that's the things we have to look at now, is watching that unemployment rate, because it is the last shoe to drop. It is a lagging indicator. Now, when you look at leading indicators and things like that, we did get a number, the Institute of Supply Management, or ISM. They showed some data based on surveys that showed that not only is manufacturing really slowing, which we know, but now it's spilling over into the important service sector that makes up the majority of the economy, like 3/4 of the economy is services. And now it's not just manufacturing, services showing some clear signs of a slowdown. Not yet into what you would call contraction, manufacturing's in contraction, but services really teetering right now, and that is a leading indicator, and that's what got the stock market to be uneasy and unsteady. Money started to flow into the bond market. We said, hey, it's not over. Rate's going to come back down. Look at the 10-year Treasury at 150. Remember when it was up in the 170s, 180 range, we told you that it was going to come back. We said it's not going to happen in a straight line. Sure enough, we're near those low, low levels that we had reached, the 142, 143. We're pretty close to those levels. I think there's a really good chance we revisit it. So look for yields to come back down. But this week, something very important will be the CPI number, Consumer Price Index, because inflation's been trending higher. The last time we got CPI, it scared the bond market because it was an 11-year high for CPI. And again, that's an important inflation indicator. Even though this is not the Fed's favorite measure, the market's smart enough to pay close attention to it. One other thing about last week that I really liked was housing data. So CoreLogic said, not only did appreciation do very well, but they're accelerating their forecasts for appreciation. And those of you that are MBS Highway members, you know we have this incredible, it's getting so much buzz about the call we did with Ivy Zelman, the number one housing analyst in the United States, and Peter Bookfar, about the smartest analyst in the stock market and economy out there. The three of us had an incredible call with Dan as well. And we talked about a lot of things that you should be looking at with regards to the future of iBuyer and the platform that could be spreading, but what some of the pitfalls are there. If you are an MBS Highway subscriber, make sure you listen to that call. Look at the incredible reviews that it's getting. It's a wonderful way for you to educate yourself on what's happening today, but what to look for in the future and how to share that with your realtors and your customers. Really put you on the cutting edge of knowledge. Now listen, it is unacceptable to be mediocre today. Did you grow up and say, hey, my goal is to be mediocre, or do you want to really be exceptional? Do you want to be great? If you do, MBS Highway will help you. Make sure you get on board. I mean, really, what are you waiting for? I mean, for goodness sakes, really? It's a small investment in a great future ahead. Or do you want FinTech and your competitors who have MBS Highway to just take the food off your table? Think about it.
PRMG continues to provide our wholesale partners across the nation with better technology, better product, better pricing, and better service. Our nationally recognized brand is more than just an image. It is a symbol of integrity. PRMG, built by originators for originators. Be sure to click on the link below for your free 30-day MBS highway trial.
This is Mortgage News Network.